Hello friends, I am Dr. Sanjay Bhatia, ENT specialist and a neuro-otologist. Today I am going to give you some information regarding blocked ear and decreased hearing. Most importantly, we should understand how our ear is. Our ear is divided into three structures: outer ear, middle ear and the inner ear. So most commonly people think that my ear is blocked and I can't hear well is wax. Wax in the ear is just a basic secretions which is having an antiseptic property of the external auditory canal, and it does cause blockage of the ear and decrease hearing. It's one of the commonest cause of accumulation is a small canal or habitual use of earbuds. We do not adequate use of earbuds to remove the wax because it tends to push the wax inwards towards the tympanic membrane. The best way to remove the wax is to meet your ENT surgeon. If you think it is blocked, we do give wax solvents to make the wax soft, and it can be removed by suction, irrigation, or by probing it out. The next other common thing we see is a fungal infection or the discharge in the external auditory canal, which does form a film or pseudomembranes in front of a tympanic membrane, causing a blockage of the ear. This can be removed by giving anti-fungal ear drops, and then after a week or so, removing them out with a suction. Further down, you have a tympanic membrane, which is a border between the outer ear and the middle ear space. So tympanic membrane, if it has a perforation, does cause decreased hearing or blocked sensation of the ear. So it can be in the different quadrants. You have a perforated eardrum, can be of acute onset, or it can be a chronic eardrum perforation. If it is acute perforated eardrum with the active discharge going on, you can have the blockage feeling in the ear. Normally in the acute situations, we do observe, we give antibiotics, we give some nasal decongestion. Usually this acute infections are ascending infections secondary to the nasal infections. If it is a chronic perforated eardrum, the best thing is to get a test of hearing called pure tone audiometry done and prepare yourself for a ear surgery called tympanoplasty. A tympanoplasty means repair of the eardrum, inspection of the ear ossicles. These are the three ossicles which are situated behind your tympanic membrane in the middle ear space. Other conditions you can get a blocked ear or decreased hearing is a cold accumulated behind your eardrum. Your eardrum may be intact, so this fluid which is accumulated could be a sterile fluid, we call it middle ear effusion, or it could be purulent infected fluid, usually common in children, and they cause a severe ear pain as well as decreased hearing. The treatment is antibiotics, decongesting the nose. Rarely we do have to do a small opening of the eardrum called myringotomies. Other condition where you have decreased hearing and a blocked sensation of the ear is fixation or immobility or discontinuity of the ear bones or the ossicles. Depending on the various situation, you can do the ossicular reconstruction if there's a discontinuity or erosion of the hearing bones. In case of fixation of the bones of hearing, you have to work on and around the fixed ossicle. Usually it is the stapes. We do a stapedotomy procedure, and we put an implant of either Teflon or a gold implant or a titanium prosthesis. The last concern is your inner ear space or organ of hearing called cochlea. Usually the hearing loss, which is neural in origin, is causing the blockage of the ear. So you feel that I can't hear and my ear is blocked. The eardrum is normal. The middle ear spaces are normal. There is no infection. So what could be the cause? Get a pure tone audiometry done. It will show you and document that your nerve of hearing in particular frequencies are going weak. In case your social life is not affected, you can go on with your life. But if you think that socially you are not hearing well, please meet your audiologist and get a hearing aid done. Lastly, there are nerves of hearing which come into the cochlea. There can be some tumors called acoustic neuroma which can cause decreased hearing. And other expected things are the acoustic traumas, the injuries, the head injuries, and the central hearing loss. So these are the few common causes of decreased hearing and the blocked ear. Thank you very much.